wasn't always the possibility of a negative outcome, but I was prepared from the outset to pay the ultimate price, even if that meant imprisonment. The court's decision today is indicative that the judge understood and expressed this case appropriately. As the judge mentioned, the importance of passwords and privacy cannot be overstated. Today's judgment, based on the judge's and prosecution's acceptance that I am of good character and worthy of belief, highlights the absurdity of Schedule 7 law. They accept that at no point was I under suspicion, and that ultimately this was a matter of having been profiled at the court. There are important implications for our collective privacy as Schedule 7 acts as a digital strip search. I took the decision to not raise the details of an important torture case before my arrest. And ultimately, I have been convicted of protecting the confidentiality of my client. If privacy and confidentiality are crimes, then the law stands condemned. Cage and I are glad we brought this case, and the result indicates that our only option is to change the law. Schedule 7 actively discriminates, and this will hopefully be the start of a number of legal challenges as more people take courage to come forward. We will be appealing this decision, and we have won the moral argument. Thank you.